We're back. You're watching CNN. I'm Brooke Baldwin. A stunning call to repeal the Second Amendment is perhaps the most radical proposition in the gun debate. So to hear it from a retired Supreme Court justice is simply quite stunning. In an opinion piece penned for the New York Times, John Paul Stevens writes that a constitutional amendment to, quote, get rid of the Second Amendment, quoting him, would do more to weaken the NRA's ability to stymie legislative debate and block constructive gun control legislation than any other available option. So with me now, Rob Astorino. He was a Republican nominee for governor here in New York and a former county executive in Westchester County, New York. Also with me, Paul Callen, CNN legal analyst, and Kirsten Powers, CNN political analyst and columnist for USA Today. So let's dive right in, shall we? Rob, first to you. When you read this piece, retired Justice Stevens calls the Second Amendment a relic of the 18th century. Why is the way it was written still relevant?
The good news is this story takes us away from Stormy Daniels for about 15 minutes. But other than that, there's really no news here. He said this 4 or 5 years ago, too, but his op-ed in the Times is what's getting the attention in the middle of a heated debate nationally with the Parkland massacre. You know, his decision in the Heller confirmation 10 years ago, to me, is frightening in that he basically takes the stance that no individual should be able to have a gun for their own self-defense in their home. That's really what his position is. To get the Second Amendment...
Actually, before we get into Heller, because I think that's getting deep, just tell
me
why...
It gets into his kind of thinking.
Why do you think something written in the late 1700s is still relevant?
Because the common use is what the term is for today, right? They didn't have television and radio back then, and yet we still have First Amendment protections on TV today. Mm-hmm. They didn't have an AR-15, but they had the weapons that they used then, and they were protected. So you can't make that argument of what was in 1780 or 90 is not relevant today because it's relative of what they were using back then.
We were talking about office earlier, and I think it's just reminding people this was, you know, Thomas Jefferson, the reasoning, and this is what Justin Stevens pointed out in this piece, and his desire for the people to, quote, protect themselves against tyranny in government. You tell me, same question, is it still relevant today? And will this help, you know, we're all in Washington or around the country for all these, you know, March for Our Lives marches, and you know what these young people are looking for. How does this help them achieve what they want?
When the amendment was adopted, one of the things Jefferson said was the tree of liberty has to be watered occasionally with the blood of patriots and tyrants. And he said that because there was a fear that the president of the United States might become a monarch and take the liberties, the civil liberties of American citizens. So if you had a well-armed state militia and individual citizens armed, that would be something to prevent sort of tyranny in the United States. Now, you have to fast forward to modern day America. First of all, is there even any possibility that if somebody has a gun in their home, that they'd be able to use that to successfully overthrow the government of the United States? I don't think we think in those terms anymore. And through the years, as the court has looked at the amendment, it's made it clear that you can ban certain kinds of weapons. You could ban the AR-15, for instance. We've banned machine guns in the past, which are guns that shoot multiple bullets on one pull of the trigger. So, but the one thing that the Heller case said, the case that Stevens is upset about, is that the right to bear arms is an individual right. Now, up until Heller, the court had said really it had to do with the wording that a well-armed state militia being necessary, the right to bear arms is permitted. That's how the Constitution words it. But in Heller, they said, well, that thing about the militia doesn't really apply anymore, but the operative clause is individuals have the right to bear arms.
He was one of four to dissent in Heller, as he pointed out, and he, to quote him, Kirsten, he says, Heller has provided the NRA with a propaganda weapon of immense power. How do you see it?
Well, I think, to your point and to the point that I think that Justice John Paul Stevens is making here is that the jurisprudence until very recently was actually, as much as you're trying to act like he's sort of this outlier and he's this extremist, actually was what he is saying, which was there wasn't an individual right to bear arms. I mean, I'm not a lawyer. I did go to Georgetown Law School for a year and a half. I took constitutional law, and that is what we were taught. There was no individual right, that this was about a well-armed militia. So this actually isn't this far-left point of view. It's something conservatives don't like, but we don't really talk about it because people have been sort of indoctrinated with this idea that this right exists. Now, that said, I don't think it's a political solution to repeal the Second Amendment. I don't think people are going to go for it. Mm-hmm. But what's very clear, and this is clear even in Heller, that absolutely the government can tell you what kind of guns you can and can't have. This idea that we keep hearing from people saying, you can't tell me how I defend my home, is just not true. It's quite clear that the government does have the right to do that.
Why do you think Americans don't believe that or take that?
Well, look at all the failures with these mass shootings, all the failures of government, those who were supposed to protect. The system collapsed and the authorities, the government, failed. But more than that, let's take a scenario of someone is entering your house in the middle of the night. You wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning. You hear something downstairs. You've got young kids down the hall. You call 911, and maybe in 2-3 minutes, somebody might get to you. But the incident, whatever would happened, would have already happened. Now, do you want that ability to protect your family? Or do you want to sit back and wait for somebody to maybe come after you're already shot?
I would love to address this. So I grew up in Alaska in a house with at least a dozen guns. I mean, I grew up shooting guns. We actually lived not near other people, so we were actually taught to defend the house with guns. We didn't have any semi-automatic weapons. We had shotguns. And we felt perfectly safe, and so did everybody else. So the issue isn't about whether or not someone could have a shotgun in their house. The issue is, like, why are people walking around with weapons that were created for war?
It really has to do with...
To your point about shootings, yeah. There is a theme with the types of weapons that are used.
It has to do with the kind of weapons. And always, even going back to the time of the Founding Fathers, there was a recognition that you couldn't carry, you know, a bazooka or some kind of, you know, weapon that an army would have. Mm-hmm. But you did have the right to defend yourself in your home. Clearly, that's what the courts have said. So I think the Second Amendment as it exists permits the government to restrict certain kinds of weapons. We don't have to repeal the Second Amendment. Justice Stevens is correct that if you repeal the Second Amendment, yeah, you could do any kind of gun control that you want. But we can't even pass a law in this country placing minimal restrictions on guns. It takes 2/3 of the Senate and the House of Representatives, as well as 2/3 of the state legislatures, to amend the Constitution. That's not happening in the current political
arena. Go. Thank you also very much. Again, it's just an interesting read from somebody who was, you know, nominated by a Republican president, but did tend to lean left in some of his opinions on the highest court.